Okay, so on the previous video, we ran our simulation for a month, and I'm going to go back to our Run Manager window here. Change this to annual simulation. It still has our weather file, but I want to add some other variables here. So what I'm going to do is go to our status window again and open up the RDD. And what I want to look at is under zone. Let's see, because basically in the SketchUp plugin, you can load surface or zone objects, other objects. Can be viewed in results viewer, but not on the geometry in SketchUp plugin. So I want the zone system sensible heating and cooling rate. So I'm going to copy all these here. Actually, let's go one more and copy that. So I'm going to close this. I'm going to paste these in here. We have a little glitch right now. I'm going to first add an extra line return here. Semicolons separate fields and commas separate fields and semicolons separate objects, and after this exclamation point are comments that should not matter, but it's making our system not happy. So for now we need to delete these. That isn't something that you should always have to do, but so for now I'm going to do that here and get rid of this. So we're still going to have our same two surface reports that we had before. Now I'm going to add in these zone specific reports. Something I was going to mention here, this hourly is a frequency, and you can change that, and this is going to show how you can use the EnergyPlus documentation. So I'm going to copy this output variables object here, and I'm going to go to Programs, EnergyPlus 6, Main Documentation. This is your friend, particularly this search document here. It will let me search a term across all of the PDFs, and I know that I'm actually looking for the input-output reference. So here I can see all the occurrences of output variable. It's going to show it to me in the index here, and it's going to jump down to page 2149. So for each object, you can look at a description of what that object has and then the fields that are included. And the particular field I want it to look at is the frequency. So we can see there's hourly, which is our default, but you can switch it to daily or monthly or run period, environment, annual, and there's actually a few more up here, detailed and time step, that have their own description. I'm not going to get into how all those work, but generally you change it to monthly instead of hourly, and it will aggregate all that data in a monthly time step instead of in an hourly, and time step would actually typically be 15 minutes. If you scroll down further, you can learn more about what reporting frequency is. So I'm not going to change those now, but all you would do is change hourly to a different term. So for now, I'm just going to leave those the way they are and run the simulation. And I'm going to pause this and come back, because it's probably going to take 2-3 minutes to run, which will not make for exciting video. But let me show you what you can do here. This gives you the typical output you're used to seeing in the terminal on the Mac, or the DOS window in Windows, and so I'm in February. So we will come back and we will be in December, and then we'll pick up where we were. Okay, so we are back, and you can see we've finished our simulation. It took 2 minutes, but we do have 8 zones with ideal loads, zone loads in all of them, so that's why it took some time. So I'm going to close this now, and we're going to have a new tutorial after this that's going to pick up showing how to view the simulation results in SketchUp as well as in Results Viewer.